Hey everybody, ChristopherOdd here. Welcome back. This is XCOM 2, Operation Shadow Beast. We need to hack the Resistance computer. Hopefully Looch is in a good position to do that. He's the one who's best equipped anyways. So a couple of quick questions that have come up a lot over the past little while. Number one is, can I use the character pool that you're using? Yeah, absolutely. The link is down below every single video, and I update it pretty regularly. There's now 613 as of when I'm saying this. 613 soldiers. So if you want to use these soldiers instead of randomly generated ones, feel free to download the character pool. Second thing is, will I be recruiting more rookies? Probably. And my thought process for the Psy Lab is to get it up to running two Psy operatives at any given time and pumping rookies in through there to kind of see what kind of combinations prevail. And going from there. So we'll see how that part works out. I'll probably need other rookies. We're not going to be done anytime in the near future, so I will probably have to recruit a few more. And then the other question that kind of ties along with that is, will I be continuing XCOM when I'm finished this campaign? Absolutely. Like, I expect that as soon as I'm finished the campaign, I'm going to fire up a new one, get a whole new batch of recruits, and XCOM will be a staple on the channel for a very, very, very long time. With some other cool things planned, XCOM 2 related, not just the playthroughs. So, yeah, I hope that covers everything, but let's get in here with Loxley, Polo, Aeneas, Looch, Andromeda, and fan favorite, Norwild. We've got, we had some Tracer rounds. I think we have good Venom rounds or the Dragon rounds on somebody. I think it was Dragon rounds. We've got Looch for hacking, rapid fire, Loxley for just general ass kicking, Polo for leadership, Tommy for blowing shit up. In this area.
Unfortunately, the aliens were quick to eliminate the operative, but as far as we can tell, the data is critical to the aliens' latest operation. We're moving in to recover what we can. Eliminate all enemy contacts and secure the area. Access the network before they have time to lock down the connection.
So, we actually need to grab these processing facility schematics, and we're doing so in the slums district called Blood Junction. Here we go.
Menace 1-5, this is Avenger. The access point we're after is just ahead. Move to secure the area. Expect hostile resistance.
Okay, so here we go. Now, I've had pretty bad luck with Windows, like revealing us when we run next to it. So I'm gonna take out Aeneas maybe this way. I'm kind of thinking, since we're so close to the objective, we've got a nice kind of ledge here that we could use, and I'm thinking we should go ahead and try and do that. Let's bring Aeneas in. Nothing so far. Okay, let's bring him up top. Nothing but birds. All right. Looch, I'm gonna have you move up as well. Tommy to the couch. Is that beer? There's beer on the couch. Somebody left a full case of beer and another six pack of cans up top with some Bluetooth speakers, presumably. Probably outdoor versions. You know, just because you don't want to get everything ruined. Let's bring Loxley up.
Twice.
Oh, this is bad. Uh-oh. Oh, look at you guys. Okay, that's cute. Andromedon and a Muton. You don't normally see that pack running around. Let's bring Nora up.
Roger that.
And let's bring Polo up. Okay, we have to remember, Polo has a couple of special abilities as a leader. Number one, we get a little bit more resources from missions. Number two is we can kind of focus. Oh man, where are they going? Okay, great. We can focus fire, which gives armor piercing, so it ignores basically one of the armor points. I'd originally thought that this shredded the armor, but I think it just ignores one point of armor. That's my understanding anyways. But it also, for each consecutive shot on the same target, gives an additional aim bonus. Now, this is not good. That's kind of prohibiting me from getting where I want to be.
Understood. Moving out.
Now, Loxley, what I'd like to do is set down a kill zone at some point to break our concealment. Let's move Andromeda in. Let's move Luch in. And the others... Oh, actually, Nora would have a shot from here. This could work.
Roger that.
Aeneas, I actually have a better idea. Why don't we move you over here to keep an eye on those guys? I actually should have checked. Okay, good. No civilians. And we could just move Polo into the middle here. Be launching grenades majority of the time anyways. Oh, what's that? I think we just got a little sneak peek up there.
Oh no. Got it covered. On overwatch. On overwatch.
Alright. So they're cruising around this side. That's not great, because I'm pretty sure that's still going to flank. Yeah, that's still flanking this area. What do we have going on in the Sentry Tower? Let's check this out. Because if there's just like a, you know, kill all enemies hack instantly, then I might give it a shot. That would be ideal. Oh, cool. Okay. So this is squad site for one soldier, Luch in this case, or squad site. 50-50 there. I think I'm just going to take the 100% because, I mean, it gives us an increase to our tech score. We get the squad site, I guess that's cool. And yeah, I don't even think we really need it, but just the guaranteed hack is nice. I mean, the weapon fall off, I guess it's not so bad with everybody other than our Rangers, but I mean, I could still see it being value add, I suppose. Okay, let's do this. Let's bring Tommy in. Let's bring him up here. I want to see if we have a group back here. We certainly do.
Forces spotted.
Okay, are they patrolling though? That's the question, because if they're not patrolling, and all of a sudden we expend our kill zone, I'm gonna be really disappointed. But at the same time, let's see. If we lay it in such a way where if these guys walk back to the left, then they're gonna be caught in it anyway. Let's lay it down. And let's overwatch here. Here, here. Nora. And Pius, if you get flanked, I want you shooting. I'm hoping that they start to walk back, patrol back the other way. Son of a bitch. Oh, that's the worst. Alright, kill zone down. Gonna have to do this the old-fashioned way. We do have this new fancy acid bomb, which is going to shred armor and leave like a giant pool of acid that does damage over time. So we could actually do this. And what else do we have? We've got two over here. Thinking this is not a bad start. Try not to kill that civilian if I don't have to. Let's kick it off here with Polo. There we go. Bye-bye armor. That's so strong. I think it shreds four guaranteed, so. Yeah, he's pissed. Oh, shit. Okay, we've got a shield bearer back there. An Archon. Yeah, this is fantastic. It's fantastic news. Not really. Okay, what do we have? What can we use? We could drop this guy through the floor, which is, you know, a pretty good option when you think about it. We've got a mimic beacon on Aeneas as well. I'm thinking, I don't think we can hit both of these guys, unfortunately. Man, I would really like to take down that Andromedon. We also have the Archon to worry about. The only other really decent thing here is the grenade from Aeneas, but he's so much more powerful in other ways. I don't know if I want to reposition just to throw a grenade on this guy, but if we leave him up there, that could be a bit of a problem. So, question is, maybe we just take the shot. We could finish off the Muton. Use Implacable to reposition ourselves.
That's right. They're onto me.
And then try and blow this guy up. That's what I'm thinking. Let's see though. Because it's going to have to be Tommy that takes that shot. Or throws that grenade. And I'm thinking we just blow out that back section of the building. And I'm just considering where I want to put Aeneas then. I guess I could just bring him back here. That seems sure reasonable. Thing. Oh, I'd really like to use these grenades on multiple people. Let's go for it. Gotta hurt. Thing is strong as hell. Alright, Loxley, come on now. It's not bad. You've done exactly the bare minimum. Nora, you wanna show her how it's done? Yeah, that's right. Nice shot. Well done. Okay, now the problem is... Do I really want to waste a rapid fire on him? I don't think so. Let's start working on this guy. Nice shot. I think we will throw the beacon. Got him poisoned, which means... Oh! Lucci, baby!
Target disabled.
Oh, man. We've had a couple of sweet executions as of late. That's, yeah, that's really cool. It's really cool. I think... I think our best bet is to throw the beacon. I'm just trying to figure out... where I should throw it, though. Because I kind of want to... I want to make sure that he can see it, so I'm just testing where I'm going to have line of sight to the Andromedon. It's going to have to be over here because of the one window. So if that's the case, maybe I throw it over here. It's still flanked. Put it back here. It's a bit exposed. I'll probably have to move her up a bit. Let's bring Nora over. Oh, can I not get that one Oh, you asshole. Right there! That's where I want it. Can't have it. Alright. Okay, so hold on. Need to make sure that we have sight wherever we want to throw it. I could throw it here, but then we don't get the cover benefits. And I mean, they miss often enough where it, you know, I don't know if I have to worry about that too much, but I don't think I can rely on that. That's really, really too bad. Let's throw it down. That is not gonna last long. We don't have anybody that can shred. We could take this, get the death from above, and then take a pistol shot. Assuming that that first phase counts as a death. I think it does. I love that. Okay, now we can't see that one. I could take this shot, but we need to roll a six. Let's go on the trooper. Damn it. That's rare. You don't normally see misses from her. Keep your head down there. Oh, not good. Okay, so he's prioritized the shields. It's a pain in the ass. Wow. I love that, but I mean, holy. All right, we could try to hack this guy. We could try to skull mine the shield bearer as well. That's actually a pretty decent idea. And if it fails, then we could try and hack the Andromedon. Let's go for it. Be cool, Looch.
It's still up! Target is still up!
Oh, that doesn't sound good. Nope. Shit. Okay, well. Oh, and we can't see him! We can't see him. Unless this could be kind of cool. It's not really ideal, I don't think. But we could try and blow out that wall so that we could try the hack. And I think, yeah, we should be able to do it. I'm really putting a lot on that though, right? Because we could get up close and just totally demolish one of these guys. Maybe that's the better option. Or another thing we could do is boost our crit chances a bit. If I were to move over one, we could do that. Or, actually, maybe this is a better plan here. Maybe what we do is we take this shot, which blows out the wall, hurts the shield bearer, blows his cover. Yeah, we're going for it. Let's go, Polo. Nice job. Now let's see what the hack is like. This would be outstanding if we could get this. I would even take the shutdown, I think. Ooh, that is a tough one. An almost guarantee. I don't want to say that because we failed some pretty serious hacks in the past. But a basically 50-50 chance to control it. I think we got to go for the shutdown. Oh, just frickin' barely, man. These hacks.
We've got access.
Okay. So that gives us a little bit to focus on. We've lost our cover, though. That is actually terrible. So how do I want to handle this? I'm thinking... we've got only got EMP bombs here. Okay, so let's bring Tom back a bit. Let's go in the shield bearer. Yeah, that sounded good. Good job, Tommy. I think we just wipe this one out. Hello. She's not fucking around anymore. There goes his shield. Loxley's got decent shots here. Shows how it's done. Beautiful job. Beautiful job. This is an option if we wanted to poison ourselves. Which is not something I would really prefer that we do. And the only other option here is with Aeneas. And I think I'm going to bring him up top to get the height advantage. See what our shot's like. We could also grenade, but it's not a guarantee to kill him. 84. Come on, John. Come on, John! That's our man right there. Good job, John.
That's done.
Okay. Implacable. We want to get a little closer here because we're going to want to start doing some work. And... can't get a line of sight, but I don't think I need to worry about that. I think we can see him from back here. We still have four turns. We're doing okay. Oh no. What is this? It's a mech. And a shield bearer. And he overwatches.
Menace 1-5.
He would.
The advent network is almost entirely locked down. We're running out of time. Get to that terminal.
Okay, so... we know what we need to do. We need to get Tommy. We need to EMP bomb these guys. It looks like I can get there without triggering an overwatch. I honestly believe that we can. I'll actually bring him to this side, I think.
Let's go, Tom.
Beautiful.
Here we go.
It's only going to impact the mech, but... that removes the overwatch. And now... we've got to try and take this guy down. I'm just worried about our positioning here. With that mech behind us. Here, let's bring Aeneas back to this side. Not bad.
Burn it through ammo fast!
Rapid fire on the mech, I'm thinking. The shield bearer, like, if he does anything, more than likely he's gonna try and boost the shields. I say that like I'm super confident. 7 to 8. How much does he have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ugh! Because I know how that's going to work out. Loxley can only see these two, though. So I think what we do is we take the 100% shot over there. And then we combat protocol him, ending his career. And then okay, good. That worked out. And then Nora. Let's start plugging away here. Holy, executed! I love that. That is the best feeling. Because it's completely bullshit. You know, like, it's just like the enemy, like, they must be pissed when that happens. I mean, I would be. Okay, and now I can't really get Polo anywhere decent. I was trying to, like, my intention there wasn't even to kill that guy. I was like, well, we'll wrap him up with Polo, get some experience going. We still have the criticals. We're really close to the objective. Let's overwatch. Oh, of course you would. Okay, we don't have like a ton of time to be dicking around here. Seems like every 2 seconds, we're running into more problems.
Das ist nicht gut.
All right. I need to try and get in there. I wonder if I could see it from here with Luch. Got the EMP bomb, that's not gonna help us at all. Loxley's got good shots here on the Viper. I do like that. Nora as well. Aeneas, less so. You know what? Here's what we're gonna do with him.
Now you see me.
We're gonna reconceal. And I'm gonna throw him way up here to try and get us eyes on that thing.
We've got eyes on the objective.
Commander, there we go.
We have confirmation of the exposed access point.
That took him a while to get over there. And then I'm thinking if I bring Luch over, I'm thinking we can hack it. But maybe we're better off trying to kill these guys first and then going for the hack on the last turn, right? It's probably the better, the wiser of the two. We've got the kill zone. Let's see what Nora can do with this Viper. Beautiful. Now, we could kill the Viper with combat protocol. So that is our backup. And if we shoot at the Muton, we've got 2 rapid fires at 40%, which I'm not super confident with. Hate to say it, but it's true. We've got the EMP bomb, no thanks.
Let's move already.
We've got the acid bomb. which could benefit us quite a bit, actually. But maybe what we do... We could go for crits, or we focus fire him. It's one action, and then we could launch the acid bomb. Let's do that. And then we'll use the acid bomb to hopefully kill off the Viper as well, so we don't have to use those combat protocol. There we go. Now, I'm kind of thinking that maybe we should save a suppression here. Loxie's got a good chance of just wiping him out. Shit. That would have been great.
I've got nothing.
And now I'm thinking we take this because we're getting the plus 8 from focus fire. The other option is to take the shot with Andromeda. It's 35%. I'm just thinking that maybe suppression is the right call, but let's get the boost for Looch here. So now we're getting plus 12.
Toss me some ammo.
From focus fire. There it is. We just need to hit one of these, pretty much. Looch. Come on, buddy. Fuck. All right, someone's gonna get hurt. Somebody's in shit. We just needed the one. This does limit him. Oh, shit. All right. Thing is, he's a little bit effed up from the, you know, all the acid.
Menace 1-5, the Advent network terminal is shutting down. This is your last chance to secure the data.
I know. Give me a little faith here. Let's bring Looch over. No. Oh, okay, good.
Packing in.
Let's get in. Give me something amazing. Yes. That is massive. I'm so pumped. The lead on the alien facility is great too, but I mean, how could I not take the 100% to increase our hacking by 20? Looch is like an all-star. And we would have gotten that anyway, but still. That is awesome. That is such a huge boost. I don't even think we've seen one of those this entire campaign.
We've confirmed successful acquisition of the Advent files. Eliminate any remaining hostiles in the area.
All right. Should I try and just get closer, or let's just see if Loxley can finish him? It's tough because I'd like to get kills here with Polo, but this is just not the right. I'm just not getting the good setups. Here, let's give Nora a chance. Come on, Nora. Oh, you grazed him, though. Grazed him. A little off the top.
I'll get him next
time. There it is. All right, now we still have that...
One down,
what was it, a shield bearer, I think, that
I've
ran away?
Something.
Confirmed.
Let's start hunting.
Hostile forces spotted.
Oh, shit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, my God. Okay. Well, that's something to think about. Let's bring him up top. That worries me a lot. Let's do this. I would love to... I'd love to get this. like, if it's gonna be surrounded by poison the whole time, we can do better. We probably have hacking back up. We will have hacking back up on Looch. So we could EMP, reduce the hacking. His just got boosted. Reduce the tech score on the mech and try and use that.
Finally.
Loxley does not have Hill Zone until next turn. Let's bring her over here.
Got it covered.
Let's bring Cannibal up.
Okay, bin unterwegs. Jetzt geht nichts.
Here we go. Are they moving? Yeah, they are. Jesus. Oh, wow! That was incredible. It's those frickin' blue screen rounds. Like, they're so strong. Okay, so his tech score is decreased already. Now the question is, what are we looking at here? Looch just got a significant boost. If we could take control, could be a game changer. Ugh. Still, like, it's not that great. Oh, man. Okay, we're gonna have to think about this here. Because if we use an EMP grenade, he's dead anyways, right? Which, like, the alternative isn't great, because we're out of ammo. We could reload, shoot at this guy, but I think just taking the EMP to wipe him out is probably the smarter decision. And then Looch, what could we do with you still, though? That's the thing. Maybe the right call is to combat protocol and kill it. Or we pull back here and we hack for the stun and we stun him for a second. And then reserve the combat protocol for maybe something else that's low at some point. What I do know is we're gonna reload Loxley here for free.
Let's do this.
And then I'm like, we have to kill zone this. Yeah. We're kill zoning that for sure. I'm just not entirely sure of the best thing that we can do here. I think we're gonna EMP because that's really all that Tom can contribute at this exact moment. This Lancer is a problem, but we do have the Mimic Beacon with Aeneas, so I'm thinking that could give us a little bit of relief.
Take this!
Here we go, Tommy, baby. Nice job. Oh, beautiful, Tom. All right. So now, option number two is to try to do something. But the problem is, like, I can stay here if I want and take some shots. But is that wise? Like, I just don't think it's wise. I think we're better off falling back. What does she have going on? It's expanded mag and the repeater. Right. So we can't get a whole lot done here with her.
Oh yeah.
Get pistol overwatch. I'm thinking we go with the suppression on Polo. And then he's concealed, but I think we gotta throw the beacon in this scenario. Let's just figure out where. If I put it down here in full cover... Oh, it's not full cover. That wall's blown out. I can use this full cover. And should draw all the fire. The only thing I don't like is it's right underneath us. We could use this. It's just a matter of if we can get the mimic beacon back there. Looks like we can. Let's go. And actually...
Position compromised.
Yeah, okay, good. I was gonna say, does that break concealment? But that's the proximity mines that don't break concealment. Okay, Loxley, let's go. Oh, nice shot. That is incredibly impressive. He's buying full cover. He's gonna be a real bitch to hit for them. I'm talking about the mimic beacon like as a person now. Which it basically is. Damn, nice try.
Negative damage.
And he's moving. Man, these guys are ballsy. He can kill him if he hits the overwatch shot. Is it gonna happen, Polo?
Steh unter starkem Beschuss.
I don't know what that means. I don't speak German. Oh, that looks good! That looked good. Yeah, okay, it didn't kill him. But, Loxley... I think we probably got the Overwatch thing happening. We can't see the Overwatch, but it's like it's taking place in slow motion. And Loxley's probably there it is. Yeah. That heavy lancer just ate shit. Loxley is providing said thing. Here it is again. Alright, I'll take that.
Minimal damage.
All right. The mimic beacon took some heat, though. All right. Now, we could give crits to Looch.
Good to go.
Let's get Andromeda. Up and running. If he could take out this, just this little trooper here, that'd be very helpful. There it is. And now, I think we're gonna be okay here. I can come down here and flank this guy, and it's like, he's not gonna be having a super time. But what else can we do is the question. I'm gonna bring Looch up.
Understood, moving out.
60 on the guy on the left. Let's go for it. Nice start. Keep it up, Looch. Keep it up, Looch.
Went off the armor.
Fucking executed again. Man, that's starting to hit so often. It's amazing. It's amazing. And his is the advanced? Yeah, so it's like 10% of the time. Like, when you think about it, the amount of times he's shooting is pretty friggin' phenomenal. All right, Nora. There it is.
Wrench off the armor.
Okay. And now we're gonna try and get Polo as close as possible to get this kill. Promotion on him would be great. 30%. If it works, great. That's fine.
Nicht gut. Negativ, Waffe ist leer.
Who else do we have? We've got Pius and Loxley. Let's see if Loxley can do it. If not, we know Pius can. There it is. Shit. Is
okay,
that it?
So I got one.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure.
That was a little hectic.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
That was a little hectic. Actually, we don't get flawless missions very often, so when that happens, that's pretty cool. Yeah, okay, Mimic Beacon, most under fire once again. Most damage, Loxley, because she hit pretty much everything a couple times. Shot percentage could have been better, but yeah, overall pretty happy. We got the hacking boost on Luch, who's like, I mean, how versatile is he? He can hack pretty much anything. He's got rapid fire that's executing like all the time. It's cool. He's awesome. You just can't let him go down, that's the thing.
If we keep this up, the aliens don't stand a chance, Commander.
Andromeda got that promotion, that's true. I really don't like Chain Shot. Like, I just don't think it's that strong. Whereas, like, Volatile Mix, you get the increased radius, and everything does extra damage. And I'm pretty sure that even includes something like Flashbangs. If we launch a Flashbang with him, I think it even deals damage with Volatile Mix. Not saying that that's why I'm gonna get it explicitly, but like, he's got the Heavy Ordnance, we might as well make those grenades even better, right? So, Illyrium Core, Advanced Stock. See, a couple of, like, you know, alloys here and there. Crystals.
Excellent work, Commander.
Intel,
your
and we countered Vigilance.
Continue to bolster the resistance movement across the globe.
This was hidden, but the other one is, like, more enemies on the map, which is, it is truly something I'm not pumped about if it goes through. Okay, alien alloys, Illyrium crystals. This is good. This is pretty good. I think we gotta go there.
Plotting new course.
September 17th, 2035. I don't know, like, pacing wise, if that's good or not. Oh, gas bomb. I mean, it's not bad. I just don't think gas bombs are, like, the greatest. Like, we have one already. I'm pretty sure that's our second gas bomb. So let's get in here. What else could we build? Should I get another Skulljack? I just feel like 10 days for a second Skulljack that I don't really need isn't the greatest. I guess I could just start buying exosuits, but then we lose a slot, so there are some soldiers that would benefit from that. But like, we're using pretty much all of our items every mission, so I don't know if that is the right decision. Let's go with some ammo. We have Dragon rounds, we have Tracer rounds, we have Venom rounds, we have Talon rounds.
Sounds good, Commander. I'll let you know.
All of which are
is ready for deployment.
Awesome. Andromeda autopsy coming in 3 days.
I am sure
here
you
it is.
Find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander. The fact that
this
armored environmental suit is capable of functioning in combat well after the original wearer has expired is remarkable.
Codename Levine.
Consult with Shin for further study into this unusual behavior.
I wonder if this is a reference to Kenny Boy. Proximity mines are the best because you can throw them from concealment and that doesn't break concealment. Like, that's awesome. And then you combine, like, proximity mine, okay, on it. You find a group, lay down the proximity mine, and throw kill zone on top of that. So they move, boom, explosion from proximity mine, they all take damage. And then you get Loxley raining down kill zone fire on top of that. I mean, oh my god. It's insane. Absolutely insane. Okay, let's, we could do beam cannon, plasma lance. I think plasma lance. Like, if we get this up on Loxley, good luck.
I foresee a number of valuable applications stemming from this technology. I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
We've been dedicating a lot of our time to gathering intel. Like, we're doing, I think, pretty well in that department, actually.
Hey, Commander.
We have some money, which is nice. I think a storm gun, since we've got that money right now, would be great. Yeah, let's grab the storm gun. And then we're definitely gonna buy at least one proximity mine. At least one. We'll keep it like that for now. I always like to keep a little bit of money in the bank.
Interfacing our equipment with the alien technology still embedded throughout the ship. Most of the primary systems are now operating on some combination of our technology and theirs. My hope is to use the best of both worlds to come up with something new, something the aliens won't expect. Hey, Commander.
Okay, so the other thing is, like, the plasma lance is good, but we still have to study the codex. And then we also have to do the Blacksite Vials Shadow Project. So I'm thinking as soon as Plasma Lance is done, I'm gonna commit to doing the Codex one. Uh-oh. Faceless on every mission. I have to remember that. More enemies on every mission. Shit just got real. Okay. So now, here's what's up. So this room's empty. I'm thinking, honestly, let's build the defense matrix.
Defense, Commander, we've pushed our current power systems to the limit. We don't have any capacity to spare, which means we can't expand our facilities further.
That's true, but I think we're still okay. Like, we could even get in here. Oh no, we need four to do the comm station. We have a power relay here that we can get plus five from. We could always upgrade this to an Illyrium conduit if we have the supplies, which gives us a significant boost. And it's actually, that's not even that expensive. It's just that it takes the crystals, right? So, I think we're doing fine there. Don't have to stress too much about power.
Strategic resource located.
There's a bunch more crystals. Let's finish this relay.
Eastern United States.
And then we're gonna try and get access to Western Europe here. Hello, supply raid. We'll take that. Absolutely. Now, because of what just happened, we've got 15 enemies out there. An Andromedon, Codex, Muton, Centurion, Elite Troopers, Shield Bearers, Elite Officers, Heavy Lancers, Vipers, and Heavy Mechs. So, a lot of organic enemies, and then the Heavy Mech, which we can pretty reliably disable if we need to. The Andromedon's a bit of an issue, the Codex is a bit of a problem.
Setting course for Western United States.
But this will be pretty nice because we've got those storm guns now on our Rangers. So let's bring out Loxley here. We're gonna bring out Polo. Aeneas, there's the storm gun. Let's bring El Frank to utilize another storm gun. And I'm thinking, maybe with him. Where's that proximity mine? There it is. And then we could go dragon rounds. Who else do we want to bring? I guess Tom, he just got volatile mix. And do we want to bring the EMP grenades? Do you want to bring two of those? Maybe just one. Maybe we only really need just one of those. And then we could carry the EMP here. The flashbang could be nice too on him though. Gotta bring Looch. I mean, he's so strong. Maybe instead of the Venom rounds, take a flashbang on him. Thing is, I want him shooting, right? Maybe that's not the best call. Let's do this. Let's take a flashbang here. He's got the acid bomb, which still does damage, but also removes a shitload of the armor. So we've got a flashbang. We can have an emergency flashbang with Looch, just in case something crazy happens and we need it. We've got one EMP grenade, two plasma grenades. We've got the proximity mine. We've got Loxley laying down cover fire. With the Talon rounds, bonus critical chance of 20. That's really good. And then the plus one damage if we do crit is nice. I just wonder if, like, because of the amount of organic enemies, maybe we want the Venom rounds. Still does bonus damage. And it's not bonus on the crit, so... Nice thing about crit is it's going to deal significantly more if it does. It's kind of a tough call. I think let's stick with the Talon rounds. It's been working. So, Loxley, Polo, Aeneas, Elfrank, Andromeda, Looch. We've got 15 enemies out there. Very difficult. Operation Falling Skies coming up. Wish me luck, guys. Goodbye.
The world you once knew is no more. Earth is now ruled by the Advent Coalition and their alien masters.